Here's Tracy Miller with the sights and sounds of this year's event.
St. Paul's Carnival couldn't have hoped for better weather, and the streets were packed as the procession set off, led by a Bristol bus. This year's celebrations were in honour of the Windrush generation and those that took part in the Bristol bus boycott. All ages here enjoying the spectacle, three generations of this family who live in St. Paul's.
I love it, I love the noise and the people. And it's a bit quieter than it used to be early in the morning, but, you know, it's pretty noisy now.
For the Bristol schools who've spent months making costumes and practising their dancing, it was a chance to perform. The carnival, a Bristolian tradition for over half a century, celebrated with costumes and visitors from around the world.
Where are you from?
I come from Indonesia, Jakarta.
And visitors from across the country.
We come fairly regularly, we come all the way from Manchester, just for the carnival.
It's really good, the music, the food, the atmosphere, it's buzzing.
So how does Bristol's carnival compare to London's bigger Notting Hill carnival?
It feels more comfortable, more friendly, more like a community.
Organisers describe the event as a success and thank the local community for their support. This morning, as the streets were cleaned, some residents had some points to make.
There wasn't enough bin and there wasn't enough toilet for the people that have come here. But it was all right. There was nobody fighting and getting in trouble.
Yeah, the festival was really great. Yes.
Those who put on the carnival say they're determined to keep it going and are asking for anyone who enjoyed it to help them fund next year's spectacle. Tracy Miller, BBC Points West, Bristol.